She has been open about her battle with depression and is currently an ambassador for mental health charity Mind. And Frankie Bridge has admitted she is scared of being the poster girl for the disorder as well as opening up about her family life in a candid chat on Thursday's edition of Loose Women. The Saturday singer, 29, opened up about struggles she has faced with the condition and said, "While she relishes using her voice to raise awareness, she doesn't want it to define her. She said, "It's refreshing that everyone knows, but we are. I was, and sometimes still am scared of being the poster girl for depression. That's the one who's always sad, you know. I know that's probably not how people think, but it makes me nervous of doing too much. I'm not embarrassed of it, but I don't want it to define who I am." The Strictly Come Dancing finalist said she had suffered from anxiety from a very young age. In 2012, she revealed she had been battling depression after she was forced to take a hiatus from the Saturdays during which she was hospitalized for treatment. The star later said she had been suffering from depression since the age of 15, when she was in pop band S Club Juniors. She said, "I used to have an inhaler and numerous blood tests as I always had stomach aches and stuff. It wasn't until the Saturdays that I realized what it was and went to the doctor, but I instantly thought, if I saw a therapist I must be crazy, so it took me a long time to come around to that." "I genuinely believe, if mental health had been spoken about as much as it is now, my anxiety wouldn't have got to the point it did. It got to the point where I couldn't cope with everyday life. I was never suicidal, but I thought people might be better off if I wasn't here. I felt worthless. I had to become a character of myself to walk into a room and be Frankie from the Saturdays. When asked if the spotlight made things worse for her, the brunette beauty said, "I don't really know. Luckily back then social media wasn't as big as it is now, so I wasn't as aware of what people thought of me. It was more the tiredness and keeping it a secret, pretending to everyone I was okay. The mother of two, who is married to former footballer Wayne Bridge, 38, said having her children Parker, 4, and Carter, 2 helped her deal with the condition, even though she initially feared she would get postnatal depression. She said, "For me having children made it better. Everyone thought I'd get postnatal depression, and so did I, so we were on top of it. I'm worse when I'm pregnant. Wayne helped so much. It happened early on in our relationship and he could have walked away from it, but he didn't. That's why it's important to talk about it, not just for people suffering, but those around them, as they don't really know what to say. I've got two young kids now. Back in the day I could have stayed in bed all day, and that's not healthy, so the boys are good in that way. But some days I do feel like doing that. Frankie." who juggles her television commitments with motherhood to her sons, said she finds it difficult to leave her sons behind when she is working. She said, "Once I'm away I miss them but I'm okay, but it's the build-up to going away." "I went on my honeymoon and I already had my first son. I didn't have a panic attack, but just suddenly started crying. Wayne was like, what is wrong with you? And I said, we haven't done a will. We haven't done anything." The What About Us hitmaker said she struggled to make friends with other moms when her family moved to a new area. She said, "I knew no one, and I was so busy I didn't have time to make friends. So, when I had my first I went to every mom and baby group, but I had nothing in common, and it was really hard." "I ended up finding one that I liked, but it's hard as a grown-up to make friends and hard as a mom to make friends just because they have kids." The stunning star has now teamed up with Lloyd's Mental Health UK for a new campaign using the hashtag number #JetainSideOut. Frankie said, "It's all about trying to end the stigma and get everyone talking. For me, any chance I try and get as involved as possible, I've openly spoken about my depression and anxiety, and I've noticed a massive difference how much everyone talks about it now, but still think there's a lot further to go."